we started our discussion about probability, and in probability we said that probability means what? Getting the desired result number of times. See, now suppose if I will toss a coin, coin, it will either give me heads or it will give me tails. Now suppose I have tossed a coin say 20 times, and say 12 times I got a head, 8 times I got a tail. Now one more time if I toss a coin, what is the probability that I will get a head? Now that one more time, you are not going to concentrate on that one more time. It is just given as a statement. But what data do we have? Already the coin was tossed how many times? 20 times. Means the total number of outcomes present with us are 20. Correct? Because 20 results are there with us. 12 times heads, 8 times tails. And out of those 20, how many times there was a tail? 8 times. So number of times the desired result has occurred. Has occurred means it has already occurred in the available data. Number of times a particular observation has occurred, outcome has occurred, divided by total number of outcomes. That is going to give us a probability. You will remember the definition like this only. Number of times the event occurs. Remember, it's a very easy chapter, very important chapter. Remember, again, I am repeating, stressing on the formula. Number of times the given event occurs divided by total number of outcomes. Clear a formula? Number of times the given event occurs divided by total number of outcomes. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Start writing.
Hello.
Probability. I am probability write down. We'll first write the basic things. A few basic things we'll write, and then we'll come to the definition. Probability of any experiment. Is the chance, probability of any experiment is the chance of getting a desired outcome. Probability of an experiment is the chance of getting a desired outcome. Random experiment. Now, what is a random experiment? An experiment that is performed with a definite purpose in mind and which can give different expected results is said to be a random experiment. Is said to be a random experiment. What did I say? An experiment that is performed with a definite purpose in mind and which can give different expected results is said to be a random experiment. Is said to be a random experiment. See, for example, as we say, tossing a coin. When we toss a coin, we have a purpose in mind. We want to decide who is the winner of the toss. Okay, generally in a game, so that the player will select either batting or bowling, or they will select the attacking side in a football match. So that purpose is definite in our mind. Why are we tossing the coin? Because we have some purpose in our mind. Because we want to decide which team should get the advantage of taking the call. So that is the purpose. And it can give different expected results. So tossing the coin can either give head or tail. It is giving us different results. When I throw a dice, I'm playing a game of Ludo. I'm playing a game of snakes and ladders. So that purpose is in my mind. And I'm going to get now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. 6 different outcomes. So that is called as a random experiment. Okay. 2 things are required. Purpose and outcomes. Are you understanding, children?
Yes, sir.
Example. Tossing a coin or rolling a die or drawing a card from a pack of cards. Or tossing 2 coins simultaneously, etc. Tossing 2 coins simultaneously, etc. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
All these are different experiments. Now, what is an event? What is an outcome? So, random experiment. Event. What is an event? An event is a part of experiment. You should know these definitions. That is why I'm giving you these definitions. Okay. An event is a part of the experiment. In other words, it is a possible outcome of the experiment. Event is a part of the experiment. See, now I'm performing an experiment of tossing a coin. First, write this definition of event. Event, or even you can write other word for it is outcome. Event or outcome. An event or outcome is a part of the experiment. In other words, it is a possible outcome of the experiment. Now see here. When I am tossing a coin, what are the possible events? What may happen if I toss a coin? Either I will get a head or I will get a tail. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So these become the events. These become the outcomes. And now we are going to find the probability of these outcomes. How many times these events are occurring? Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
So write down probability of an. It is also called as empirical probability. Okay. Probability or empirical probability. Probability or empirical probability of an event. So the probability of any event is the chance of getting the desired, getting the said event. Jiski baat kar rahe, the getting the event about which we are speaking. So probability of an event is the chance of getting the said event, the same event, of getting the said or same, you can say, in the set or in the brackets you put the same event if the same experiment is performed one more time. Probability is what? Is the chance of getting the same result, of getting the same event or result if the same experiment is performed one more time. See, I had tossed the coin 20 times. If one more time I toss the coin, what is the probability of getting a tail? It is 8 upon 20, 2 upon 5. Means every 2 out of 5 tosses, there is a tail. Are you understanding? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And now comes the important formula. Probability of event A is given as P of E. This is probability of event E. Event A, sorry. P of event A is equal to number of times event A occurs divided by total number of outcomes. Compulsory for each and every probability sum, we are going to write this formula. Number of times event A occurs divided by total number of outcomes. Fine?
Yes, sir.
So probability of event A, number of times event A occurs divided by total number of outcomes, total number of. Trials. Write down. Page number 277. Textbooks closed. Page 277, example 1. A coin is tossed 1,000 times with the following frequencies. With the following frequencies. Head occurred 455 times and tail occurs 545 times. Compute the probability of each event. Compute the probability of each event. Which are the two events? Which are the two events?
Head and tails.
Tails. How many times head has occurred?
455.
And how? What are the total number of outcomes available with us?
1,000.
1,000. So what is the probability going to be?
455 upon
1,000. Upon 1,000. Very good. So write down solution. Let event A is equal to occurring ahead. Yes or no?
Yes. Event yes, A sir.
Is equal to occurring ahead. We know that. This is how we are going to solve. Very easy sums are there. No need to worry at all. But the writing part has to be very, very clear. Probability of event A is equal to number of times A occurs divided by total number of outcomes. So in our case, probability of what? Of what? Getting ahead.
Occurring ahead.
Probability of getting ahead is equal to what? Number of times head occurs. Yes or no?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Divided by total number of outcomes. Number of times head occurs divided by total number of outcomes. So P of getting a head, probability of getting a head is equal to 455 divided by 1000. At the most, you can write 0.455 because there are three zeros, three decimal digits after the decimal. Or else you can keep it as it is. 455 upon 1000 is also okay. If at all it is a MCQ question and in the reduced form, then you divide by 5. 5, I think 591s are and 5200s are. 91 upon 200. Yes or no? No need to reduce. No need to reduce. If you reduce, it is okay. Even if you don't reduce, still it is okay. 91 upon 200. Am I right? Yes or no, children?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Find out the next. Probability of getting a tail. Probability of getting a tail. Will be what? Number of times tail occurs. So how upon total, how many times is the tail occurring? 545 upon 1000. 5105 upon 200, na? 109, sorry. 109 upon 200. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Till here, everybody has understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm going to tell you one more important thing. Everybody will pay attention. See. Now, tossing a coin has got two outcomes, either a head or a tail. Rolling a dice has got six outcomes. Either you'll get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Anything out of 6 you can get. But the total probability of all the outcomes will be 1. Maximum 1. Probability can never go beyond 1. 1 means what? 100%. 100 out of 100 times the desired result is occurring. For example, probability of if I want an experiment, sun rising in the east. I am calculating the probability for 1 year, 365 days. Out of 365 days, how many times will the sun rise from east? How many times?
365.
All 365 days. Are you understanding? So 365 upon 360. Number of times sun rises from east. 365 times. Total number of days. Total number of outcomes. 365. So 365 upon 365. 1. Maximum probability is 1. Probability never goes beyond 1. Are you understanding? Are you understanding?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, when I said the coin was tossed 20 times, 12 times I got a head, 8 times I got a tail, because there are only two possible outcomes. Probability of getting a head was 12 upon 20. Probability of getting a tail was 8 upon 20. And when I add these two outcomes, 12 upon 20 plus 8 upon 20 will give me 20 upon 20. The total of all the probabilities is always 1. Of a given experiment. Are you understanding what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
Now in this case also, here also if you see, 455 upon 1000 is the probability of getting a head, and 455 and 545. So if I add the two probabilities, see what, if I were to do this, probability of getting a head plus probability of getting a tail is what? 455 upon 1000 plus 545 upon 1000. Common denominator is 1000, and this becomes 455 plus 545. That is 1000 upon 1000. That is equal to 1. The total probability of all the elements becomes 1. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
So now, important question. Suppose if probability of getting a head is 0.35, then what should be probability of getting a tail? What will be probability of getting a tail? 0.65, because the total probability has to be 1.00. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So 1.00 minus 0.35 actually gives me the answer 0.65. So that the combined probability has to be 1. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
So these kind of questions also, yes, come into the exams. They will give you probability of one event and ask the probability of another event. The total has to be 1, because the total probability is always 1. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now write down a note. So below this question, first write a note. Note, write down. I'm taking the note on the next page, and again we'll go back to the previous page. In the note, write down. The sum of probabilities of all the events, sum of probabilities of all the events of a particular experiment is always 1. For example, in the above case, the experiment had 2 possible events. The experiment had 2 possible events. Which were the 2 possible events? Yes, getting a head or getting a tail. Getting either a head or a tail. Probability of head is equal to 455 upon 1000. Probability of tail was 545 upon 1000. Thus, sum of probabilities of all the events is equal to P of H plus P of T. Is equal to four 455 upon 1000 plus 545 upon 1000 is equal to 455 plus 545. Common denominator is 1000. Whole divided by 1000 is equal to 1000 divided by 1000 is equal to 1. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do we understand, children, that sum of all the probabilities is 1?
Yes, sir.
Now, one more question. Now, one more question, important question. I want the range of probabilities, okay? Range of probabilities. Means what? Probability will lie between which and which number? Now, listen to me first. We said that probability is getting a chance. Now I will give you a same example of sun rising. We found out the probability of sun rising in the east. What was the probability of sun rising from the east? Suppose for 1 year data we have collected. One. It was 365 out of 365. 365 times the sun was rising from east out of 365. Not a single day it rose from west. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Means highest probability is 1 because it's going to be 100%. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suppose I am calculating the data for 300 days. Suppose I have a data of 300 days. So how many times the sun will rise from east in 300 days?
300.
Okay. Or will it come 600 times in 300 days?
No.
Will it come 400 times? Will it come 500 times? No. Will it ever come even 301 times out of 300?
No.
No.
Means it can never cross 1. Probability can never cross 1 because out of probability, 300 out of 300, 1. 300 upon 300, 1. Highest probability is 1. Clear, eh?
Yes, sir.
I will never get a probability bigger than 1. Okay. Let me go for the lowest probability. Kam se kam. Lowest mein lowest kya aega? Let me calculate the probability
Zero.
Of... Exactly. Let me calculate the probability of sun rising from the west. How many times will the sun rise from west?
Zero.
Zero. So what is the probability? Zero. Upon 300, that is zero. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
In your class, I will select a child at random. I am performing an experiment. Any one child I am selecting at random. Find the probability that the child belongs to grade 9. Suppose now there are 18 participants in this list. 18 of you are there. If I select anyone out of that, what is the probability that you will be from grade 9?
1 upon 18.
19 upon 18 upon 18. All 18 belong to grade 9 divided by total students are 18. So 18 upon 18 or 18 upon 19 actually, because including me for this room, if we calculate the probability, it would be 18 upon 19. Yes or no? 0.99. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me the probability that a child in this list, that a child in this list of 19 people belongs to grade 5.
Zero.
Zero.
Zero people out of 19. Zero out of 19 belongs to grade 5. Or will I say like this, out of these 19, there are minus 5 people belonging to grade 5 or minus 2 people who study in grade 5. Can I ever say like this?
No.
Will the probability ever go below zero? No.
No.
Will I ever get a negative probability? Never. never I will get a negative probability. Means the smallest probability is zero, the biggest probability is one. Clear, right?
Yes, sir.
So write down this also as an important note. Below this note, the sum of all probabilities is one. Write this as note number one. Here you can put number one. Now put number two. This is in greater details in grade 10, but you should know. And now, wait a minute. When I asked, sun rising in the east, what kind of an event is this? Can I call this? This is a sure shot event. Sure event. 100%. It is going to happen that sun is going to rise in the east. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So sure event. All the months have 28 days. 12 months.
The months have 28 days.
30 असता 30 म्हणजे 28 आहेच की 28 आहे म्हणजे प्रत्येक मंथ मध्ये 28 तर आहेच आहे. कुणाकुणामध्येच 29 आहेत, कुणामध्ये 30 आहेत, पण 28 नाहीत असं होईल का कधी? ऑल 12. ओके, व्हाट आय वॉज सेईंग, व्हाट वॉज आय सेईंग, हा शुअर इव्हेंट, द प्रोबॅबिलिटी ऑफ शुअर इव्हेंट इज द मॅक्सिमम प्रोबॅबिलिटी इज 1. येस ऑर नो?
येस सर.
We will call that event as a sure. It is going to happen. Similarly, sun rising from the west. What kind of an event is this? You give any name.
It can never happen.
So what do we call such a thing as which never happens?
Impossible.
Exactly. We will call that event as an impossible event. Correct? Sun rising in the west, is it possible?
No.
So that would be an impossible event, and probability of an impossible event is going to be zero. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So let us continue writing note number two. Certain events are sure to happen every time we perform an experiment. Example, sun rising in the east. Such an event is called as a sure event and the probability of a sure event is 1, which is highest. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Certain events can never occur, and we call them as impossible events. Example, sun rising in the west. The probability of such an event is 0. Which is lowest. Thus, probability of any event lies from 0 to 1. Yes or no? Probability will always lie from 0 to 1. Yes or no, children?
Yes, sir.
So write the final result. See how I'm writing. Therefore, 0 less than or equal to probability of any event, which is less than or equal to 1. Am I right? So probability lies from 0 to 1. Highest is 1, lowest is 0. Probability is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Let me check. Yes, we found out. And yes. See here. Note that. If you can read it over here. Note that in the above example, P of E plus P of F, event E and event F, total is 1. And E and F are only two possible outcomes. Yes or no? So did we write this also that the total probability is 1? Yes or no? Am I not audible? Am I audible, children? Am I audible now, at least?
Yes, sir.
So this is what I was saying is that the total probability is 1. Can you see here also they have shown the total probability is 1 and E and F are the only two possible outcomes. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So right now we'll stop over here for the day. Remaining examples and the exercise we will solve tomorrow. Okay. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Goodbye.